Hey, what is going on, you guys? My name is Jake, and welcome back to another video. Today, we are going to be going over my top 10 pads for the 2017-2018 season. If you do not remember, I did do this video last year, and I am going to try to make it an annual thing. We are currently in the second round of playoffs as the Toronto Maple Leafs were defeated 7-4 tonight against the Boston Bruins. So we're currently going into the second round, so I thought what a great time it would be to upload this video. So going over this originally, I had a few good ideas, and coming into this I already knew what was going to be at my number one, so stay tuned for that. Number 10, Pecorine's pads. Pretty basic, mostly like any goalie in the NHL, but something about just the blue and the yellow kind of catches my eye on this one, as when you're looking at it, you're almost intimidated, as Pecorine himself can just intimidate you. That's pretty much all I need to have to say for these. Number 9, Corey Schneider's pads. What I like about these is how good the red and the black is balanced. You have red, white, and black. I think there's a perfect balance, same with the blocker and the glove. Kind of like how everything's all stitched together, and how it's not like when you're looking at the goalie, the pads is the only thing you're going to be looking at. It's a pretty good balance. Number 8. Steve Mason's, just like Pecorine's, another one that kind of intimidates you, but at the same time is also very basic, that any shooter coming up to the goalie will say, well, you know, I'm definitely not going to shoot at his pads. That's pretty good, and that's what a lot of goalies go for. Not a huge eyesore at all. I would like if it was a little bit different on the bottom. Like, I don't really like these two shades of blue together, but I digress. They still look very good. Coming in at number 7, Martin Jones. Pretty sure I had either him or Aaron Dell higher up on my list last year. But alas, new pads came in this year, which makes Martin Jones move up a little bit higher. What do we have to say about these? They look retro, and that's what I like with a lot of these pads that some of the guys these days have. I feel like these pads wouldn't be rated as high if it weren't for the orange stitching. Very good distance between each other, very, very good stitch work by whoever made these. I got to see Arundel play one, or not Arundel, I did get to see Arundel play, but I got to see Martin Jones play a few years back, and he was wearing pads similar to this, and ever since then, I've always been hooked. Coming in at number 6, we have Maxim Legacy for the Vegas Golden Knights. Although you didn't get to see him play much, still, I like these pads. I like how it really utilizes the team colors that they have. It doesn't utilize the red, but still, it makes two warm colors kind of clash and look pretty nice. Not an eyesore, but after you have that gray jersey on, you have obviously the blocker and the glove and your stick. It looks very good altogether, and I think the pad designer did very good for Maxim Legacy. Coming in at number 5, we have Lauren Bros. Sorry if I botched this. Whatever his last name is. Okay. Kind of like Martin Jones. I like the retro style, the retro look. I like how it has the orange, then on top it's the white, and then it just has that one blue line. That's pretty much the perfect pad. And then you have the blocker, which looks very nice as well, with the orange covering the Vaughn logo, and then you have the blue. So, again, not much to say about these pads besides I like them. And yeah. Coming in at number four, Marc-Andre Fleury. What do I have to say about Marc-Andre Fleury? First of all, Cinderella story. They got the 4-0 sweep. Congratulations to the Vegas Golden Knights. Hope you do well. Kind of like with Maxim Legacy's pads. These pads might not look that good until you see him with his jersey on, all his gear on, and things like that. But even without the gear, these pads still look very nice. Sorry, I gotta readjust my mic here. These pads still look very nice. I like the color balance between the black, the gold, and the gray. Most notably on the blocker. And I think that everything is just spread out very nicely when it comes to stitching and when it comes to just the design in itself. Number two, number two, or number three, sorry. Ken Appleby, New Jersey Devils. When you talk about intimidating pads, look at somebody's and then look at these. Tell me which one's more intimidating. Just the pads themselves look like there's a face on there. It looks amazing. Now, I will say one thing. These pads look like they belong to a Carolina Hurricanes goalie more than a New Jersey Devils goalie. But I digress. They still look very nice. I've always been a huge fan of Bauer gear, what that means. The glove, the blocker, the stick, or the pads, obviously. I just love how everything is balanced out perfectly. And I believe that just it's perfect balance and everything just looks very nice on these. Number two, Scott Darling. I like the red. Now, when we were talking about eyesores, that's definitely something to think about. But when you have the logo on top, it kind of substitutes, or it kind of takes I guess brunt force for the red. If I could change one thing about these pads, it would be, you know how these are here? It would be for this to just cover those, have it be the same color all throughout. But other than that, very good pads. And number one, if you have any common sense, I think you know which one's up. Henrik Lundqvist, New York Rangers. What can I say? The king deserves pads made for a king. When I first saw these pads back in, what was it, August, September, I was very happy. I jumped out of my seat because it was like, wow. Like, whoever designed these pads, bravo. They capture the Empire State Building, the Chrysler Building, the One World Trade Center. Like, everything looks nice. The New York skyline, and then obviously you have Lady Liberty. And I also, like, I can't tell if it's like a white or kind of like almost like a tan white, but the color that they have up here looks amazing. I also like how it makes it look like this is like flowing in the wind. And then they obviously have the water right here. Just everything about this pad, or about, you know, these pads, just I love. And these by far are my favorite pads ever. And that's saying a lot. So, thank you guys for watching. If you did like it, please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share on any platform. And big thank you to the Goalie Archive for these photos. I want to make a quick disclaimer. We do not own these. These are from a website called thegoaliearchive.com. I will leave the link down in the description. And, yeah, as always,